When the Bonolet development opened in 2001, one of the best kept secrets was its sustainability profile. Energy efficient buildings combined with a 100% locally renewable energy system created a blueprint for the sustainable neighborhood. The next question was, if we can build a 100% renewable neighborhood, why can't we have a 100% renewable city? The energy system was built on existing technologies combined in a new way. Solar panels provided some hot water along with heat pumps in the sea. Surplus heat could be stored in the underground aquifer for use in the district heating system in the winter months. Cold water could also be stored in the aquifer for use in district cooling in office buildings during the summer. The city has now reached its first target of being 100% renewable for all of its internal operations by 2020. In the new environment program is to hit the target of 70% reduction in climate emissions across the city by 2030. Malmö is the city in Sweden with the most photovoltaics per capita, and the country's largest offshore wind farm is just off the coast here at Lillgrunden. Wind power is one of the key elements for Malmö to reach 100% renewable energy. And the city has already invested in wind turbines further afield and is now looking at the possibility of building closer to home. But just like in Bonolet, a lot of the innovative energy infrastructure is actually invisible. Waste incineration in 2020 provided 71% of the heat and hot water for the city and 10% of the electricity supply. An additional 10% of the heat and hot water comes from the sewage treatment works and from heat recovery from industry. And the remaining 20% used to be powered by natural gas, but is now powered by biogas.
My name is Mattias Hurtenvik. I'm head of the Sustainable City Development Team for E.ON in the Nordics. District heating in Malmö supplies 95% of the heat demand all in all, and it's really a backbone of the energy system in Malmö. And we work with district heating with hot water as an energy carrier, which gives us quite strong flexibility to change fuels or source of energy, which we've done over the decades now, going from fossil fuels basically into entirely 100% renewable and recycled energy until 2025. That's our target. The next step after that is really pushing also the CO2 emissions down. So there we will work with new technologies such as deep geothermal. We will work with looking into how we can capture carbon through either biochar production or through carbon capture and sequestration as well.
So is an energy company able to drive that transition by themselves?
In order for the energy system transformation to happen and actually accelerate also, we need a lot of collaboration. We need collaboration between system operators like ourselves and waste, water and sewage actors. We need collaboration with the public sector, like with the municipality of Malmö, and we need certainly collaboration with customers as well.
At the same time that the energy system decarbonizes, energy consumption has actually decreased significantly. Energy use per capita fell by 27% between 2004 and 2019. In the same period, the population grew by 20%, but overall energy use in the housing sector has decreased. The Bonolet partnership approach has been used in most subsequent large developments in the city, where developers come together with utilities and different city departments to define shared goals and objectives and a shared sustainability vision. And here in Hylia, resulting in a climate contract, Sweden's largest collection of passive housing, we have solar housing, a smart grid energy system, and the next development which is taking place at the moment is developers coming together in the Climate Neutral Building Partnership, LFM 30.
My name is Josefine Ellerup. I'm the strategist of urban development at the City Planning Office in Malmö.
So what is the LFM 30 Climate Neutral Building Partnership?
Elephant 30 is a local roadmap for climate neutral building and construction sector within Malmö by the year of 2030. Also, the goal that we will halve the carbon emissions by 2025 and be climate positive by 2035.
So are you just focusing on new development or is it broader than that?
The partnership is about having a climate neutral building and construction site. It means that it contains both developers or new buildings, but also operation and maintenance of existing buildings and renovation and energy and all the kind of things that are connected to our building sector.
The move towards climate neutral building will bring about the need for new materials and new supply chains, and not least thinking around circular materials. Using timber construction, such as the new car park in the Sega Park Hospital redevelopment project, but also repurposed bricks, repurposed steel, and other elements that can help to decrease the carbon footprint, as well as using things like concrete in a more sparing fashion, so more lightweight concrete structures. All of these things are being experimented with now in the shift towards a more sustainable building sector. Climate neutral building will be one of the key focuses in the redevelopment of Nyhamnen here, New Harbour. But just focusing on new buildings and existing buildings isn't going to be enough. A much broader approach is needed if we're going to hit the 70% climate reduction target by 2030. The Climate Contract Malmö has recently been launched to bring together an opportunity for the city, for local businesses, for NGOs, universities, and not least the citizens of Malmö to make their own commitments to reduce their climate impact and reduce the carbon footprint locally and influence what's happening globally.